I'm confident that this collaboration will be very beneficial to all of us. This symposium is well timed, as the world is currently facing challenges in the form of extremism and radicalism among religious followers. It focuses on such an important topic that emphasizes moderation as the principal solution to the conflict and violence that exists in the world currently, especially among people of religion. In fact, religions have consistently been criticized as a cause of conflict and violence that exists in the world today. Throughout history, religion are also blamed as the main source of this contact and never-ending clashes among mankind. Instead of looking at the cause of conflict and violence as manifestation of flawed worldviews of individuals, many have chosen to ignore the more fundamental role of religion as the advocator of harmony and peaceful coexistence. Ladies and gentlemen, extremism and radicalism, which is very close to my heart because I am the one, is very, very tough and fighting against it, does not have religious. Extremism and radicalism does not have religious. No cultural backing. There are diseases that can cause disintegration and destruction to any society. And for this reason alone, religious followers worldwide must come forward and support the agenda for moderation, as it is the best approach to address the problems and problem wars, destruction caused by extreme thinking and broad understanding of religious principles. To me, moderation is defined as to be within limits that are not excessive. It lies between two extremes, which are excess and deficiency. That is, it is to me. Al-Ghazali, the renowned scholar, states that the ultimate aim in all affairs and character traits is the mean. Since the best in all things is the mean, and both extremes are blameable.